Good morning, children. This is Marty Professor. Today we are going to explain about the chapter Globe, a model of Earth. Okay. In the previous class, we have discussed about the shape of the Earth. The shape of the Earth. Okay. In this class, we are going to discuss about the globe, which is showing the shape of the Earth and it shows oceans, it is showing oceans, continents. In the previous class, we have discussed about the globe which is showing the ocean, the globe which is showing the shape of the Earth. The shape of the Earth is in spherical. In the previous class, we have discussed about the how the geographers proved the shape of the Earth is in spherical. Okay, now in this class we are going to explain about the globe which is showing oceans and continents. If you see the globe, on the globe we can observe the large amount of the globe is covered with the blue color. Okay, on this globe we can observe the blue colored portion. These blue colored portion is represented with oceans. The oceans are represented by blue color. If you see the globe clearly, the sheets are spread over the globe with different types of colors. This is called the land parts. These are also called as the continents. Okay, these are the with the help of globe. In the previous class, we have discussed about the shape of the Earth. Okay, now in this class, we are going to explain about the oceans and continents. Okay, now oceans. On the globe, you can see the blue colored portion. This blue colored portion is notated as the oceans. Okay, as we have learned from the previous classes, there are four main oceans are covered on the Earth. Okay, there are the first one is Pacific Ocean, Atlantic Ocean, Indian Ocean and Arctic Ocean. These are the four oceans we can see on the globe. Okay, now coming to continents. If you observe the globe, the plain sheets are called as continents. Okay, there are seven continents are present on the Earth. Those are, the first one is Asia, Africa, Europe, North America, South America, Australia, and Antarctica. Okay, these are the seven continents spread on the landmass of Earth. Okay, the biggest among these all continents, the biggest continent is Asia. The biggest continent is Asia, and the smallest continent is the Australia. This is the biggest continent among these all continents, and the smallest continent is Australia. Okay. Among these four oceans, the biggest ocean is Pacific Ocean, Pacific Ocean, and the smallest ocean is Arctic Ocean. Smallest. Okay, these are the oceans and continents which were shown on the globe. Which were shown on the globe. Once again, there are four oceans are on the globe. We can see the Pacific Ocean, Atlantic Ocean, Indian Ocean, and Arctic Ocean. Okay, among these four oceans, Pacific Ocean is the biggest one, and among these four, Arctic Ocean is the smallest one. Okay, if you observe the Arctic Ocean is in the frozen shape. Arctic Ocean is in the frozen shape. Why? Because the Arctic Ocean is located at the north portion of the Earth. At the north portion of the Earth and the south portion of the Earth are covered by the ice. That's why the Arctic Ocean and also the Antarctica continent is also covered by the ice. Okay. Now coming to the continents. There are seven continents are located on the Earth. Those are the Asia, Africa, Europe, North America, South America, Australia, and Antarctica. Antarctica is fully covered with ice. That's why this is in the frozen state. The Antarctica continent, which is in frozen state. Okay. Why? Because the Antarctica continent and the Arctic oceans. The Arctic Ocean is located at the north of the globe or north of the Earth, and the Antarctica continent is located at the south of the globe. Suppose if you see in this portion, the Arctic Ocean is located, and at the bottom of the globe you can see the Antarctica portion. Okay, these two are covered with the fully ice. Okay, those are in frozen state. Why? Because those are in frozen state. Among these seven continents, Asia is the biggest continent and Australia is the smallest continent. Okay, now coming to the directions on globe. Directions on globe. Okay, in the previous class, in the previous lesson, we have discussed about the main directions. What are the main directions? There are four main directions, as we all know that there are four main directions. Those are north, south, east, and west. These are the four main directions which we have learned in the previous lesson. Okay, now try to locate these directions on the globe. Suppose let us assume that if it is the globe of model of the Earth. Okay, this is the north. At the top side of the globe, it is located at the north, and the bottom side is south. Okay, if you see the globe once again, this globe is connected from the top part to bottom part on a line. On a line that is called axis of the globe. Axis of the globe. This is the axis. When the Earth rotates around itself, it always rotates on its own axis. Okay, from north to south, we can observe this axis, and the direction of Earth rotates from west to east. Every day the Earth is rotating from west to east on its own axis. It is always rotates from west to east. Okay, this is the direction of rotation of Earth. And if you see the axis which joins the north pole and south pole of the Earth with the single line, that is called the Earth axis. On this axis, the Earth is every day rotating from west to east, revolves around the sun. This is called as axis of rotation, or the Earth's rotation on its own axis. Okay. By observing this axis, we can look at the different directions. At the top of the globe, we can look at the north direction. At the bottom of the globe, we can look at the south. From west to east, the rotation. If you see the rotation of the earth is every day rotating from west to east directions. Okay, these are the directions which we can look at on the globe. Okay, now coming to the part. The lines which we can see on the globe. The lines which we can see on the globe. Okay, if you see on the globe, there are so many lines. Lines are drawn. There are so many horizontal lines and there are so many vertical lines. Vertical lines are drawn on the globe. Vertical lines and parallel lines. These are called parallel lines. If you see the globe, we can observe. If you see the globe, There are so many lines, so many vertical lines. If you observe the globe clearly, there are so many vertical lines and there are so many horizontal lines also drawn. If you see the red mark here, this is called an equator. It means the line that divides the earth into two halves. Okay, now you can see about this. Okay, the parallel lines which we can observe on the globe, they are called latitudes. The parallel lines which we can observe on the globe, they are called latitudes. Okay, and also the vertical lines which we can observe on the globe, they are called longitudes. They are called longitudes. The vertical lines which we can see on the globe, they are called longitudes. There are about 360 longitudes are there. And coming to latitudes, there are 180 latitudes are there. Okay, among these latitudes, the zero degree latitude which divides the earth into two halves. The upper portion of the equator is northern hemisphere and the down portion of the towards the equator, that is called southern hemisphere. Okay, at the same time, the length of the latitudes is not same. Suppose if you observe the major latitude, it is having very big length. If you see, as we move up and as we move down, the length of the latitudes is varies from equator and decreases from the equator. The length of the latitudes is decreases as we move up or as we move down from the equator. Okay, if you see the longitudes, the length of all longitudes is equal. The length of all longitudes is equal and the longitude with 0 degrees, that is called Greenwich latitude. The longitude that is with 0 degrees, that is called Greenwich longitude. The longitude that is having 180 degrees, that is called as international 180 degrees longitude, that is called as international dateline. This is also called as international date like it. Okay, these are the important longitudes and latitudes. Okay, once again, if you see, coming to the latitudes, latitudes are the parallel lines which the lines are extending from west direction to east direction, west to east. From west to east, they are extending on the globe. They are called latitudes, and also these latitudes are imaginary lines. Those are not real lines. Those are imaginary lines. The imaginary lines that are extending from west to east on the globe, they are called latitudes. The length of the latitudes is not same. The length of the all latitudes is not same. Okay, there are 180 latitudes are there. Among these 180 latitudes, the equator is the biggest one. The equator that divides the earth into two halves, that is the upper portion of the equator is called northern hemisphere, and the lower portion of the equator, that is called southern hemisphere. Okay, now once again see about longitudes. There are 360 longitudes are there. Okay, the exact meaning of longitudes are the vertical imaginary lines which are drawn on the globe. They are called as longitudes. There are about 360 longitudes are there. About 360 longitudes are there. Okay. Among these 360 longitudes, the 0 degrees longitude, that is called Greenwich longitude, and the 180 degrees longitude, that is called the International Dateline. Okay, these are the important latitudes and longitudes. Then coming to what is the use of these latitudes and longitudes. What is the use of these latitudes and longitudes? With the help of these latitudes and longitudes, we can locate any place on the globe easily. With the help of these latitudes and longitudes, we can locate any place on the globe. Suppose if you want to locate England or if you want to locate India, with the help of these latitudes and longitudes, we can locate them very easily. That's why the geographers prepared these latitudes and longitudes. Okay. And one more important topic, that is hemispheres of the earth. Okay. If you see the hemispheres. Okay, this is 0 degrees latitude, equator that divides Earth into two halves, northern hemisphere, and southern hemisphere. The upper portion is called northern hemisphere, and the lower portion is called southern hemisphere. Okay, and also the Greenwich longitude or the international date line, which can divide the earth into two halves, western hemisphere and eastern hemisphere. Okay, these are the hemispheres which were formed by the major long latitude and the important Greenwich longitude. Okay, by the equator, the earth is divided into two parts, that is northern hemisphere and southern hemisphere. Okay, with the cutting of this Greenwich or international date line, the earth is divided into two hemispheres, that are western hemisphere and eastern hemisphere. Okay children, this is all about our lesson, the globe, a model of earth. Okay, we have successfully completed our lesson. I hope you have understood this lesson. Okay, thank you children.